Hello everyone, I'm Trishil and thank you for joining us. Our guest for today is a former India number one and a winner of multiple state and national level tournaments. Over her illustrious career, she has represented India in some of the biggest tournaments like the World Championships, the Asian Championships and the Uber Cup. In the year 2019, she won the prestigious Shiv Chhatrapati Award, which is the highest sporting honor by the Maharashtra government. There was a point in her career when playing for India was a distant dream, but she fought back all the odds and went on to represent India in the biggest stage. I'm talking about none other than Sayogita Ghorpade. Hi, Sayogita.
Hello. Hello, Srishil. Thank you for having me today.
Thank you so much for giving your time. How are you? How's the lockdown treating you?
All good. Nothing. I've become more lazy.
Okay.
Nothing else.
But then I'm
maintaining my workout and stuff, at least taking out few hours for my own self.
No.
And working out, like home workout and stuff.
But in Pune, I believe there were some relaxations, so you were able to practice for a few days.
Yeah, a few days I trained here at Sudhanshu's Academy. So
okay.
You might be knowing Sudhanshu.
Yeah, myself. Yeah. Good friend.
Yeah, so I was training with him for a few days and also his academy is nearby to my place. So
okay, that's great. So now how are you placed? How are you dealing with the restrictions?
Now again, the lockdown has begun like 5 days back. So I'm again back to the lockdown ka routine.
Okay.
Aram se utne ka, coffee, fir workout din mein kabhi bhi. Aisa thoda, like in lockdown, it's like when... desperate need of motivation, मतलब ऐसा लगता है कि इधर मतलब life ही खत्म हो गया है, अभी क्या करूँ?
So have you managed to find any new hobbies for yourself?
Yeah, I'm painting. Like
that's great.
My mom dad were shocked looking at my paintings. कि next day my dad went to this stationery and he got me few stuff. कि मतलब अरे ये तो अच्छा बना रहे हैं.
That's great. So Sayogita, take us please continue.
Yeah, so even like while painting and stuff, you can focus more, which I'm lacking during this lockdown. Like even when I'm working out, I'm not able to focus as much as like what I was focusing before on my workout. But
great. So that's in a way helping you to get back your focus. That's wonderful. So Sayogita, take us back to your growing years. So you are based out of Kolhapur.
Yeah.
So how was it growing in Kolhapur?
It was great. Like when I started playing badminton, I was 7 when I started playing.
Okay.
And I started because of my elder brother, Siddhant. So he used to play and he was a really good player. And then when he started playing before, like he was around 9 or 10 years old when he started. So I was just going with him to pick up the shuttles and just play around and stuff. And that's how I started playing. And actually my brother taught me like how to hold the racket because I was really tiny, like racket size, and I was not allowed to enter the court. So because all seniors used to play, senior as in 10 saal ke wagera, so all of them they used to play, and unme main bahut zyada choti padti thi, so I was not allowed to enter the court. So my first coach, Abba Tawde, like he was 70 or 75 year old, so Azoba types.
Okay.
Yeah, so he used to train me. Like before, like I started playing, like before I entered the court for few months, he just let me do wall practice and running and like few exercises, core exercises and skipping and stuff, like basic exercises. And after like 6 months or something, I started like more than 6 months. I like first time I got to play on the court and it was a great feeling.
Okay. So, sir, Sayogita, when we were speaking a couple of days back, you said that you know, there is an interesting story of you actually getting on the court for formal training. You used to only do ball practice. So, tell us about it.
Actually, what happened when, everybody was playing on the court and even I entered. So, my coach was like, you're not allowed to enter the court because you're too tiny and you don't have a racket, which, way less than what other rackets were, so you better go back home. Like first few days he didn't entertain me a lot, Then later, like I, every day I used to go and stand in front of him saying that aaj to milega kya, aaj to milega kya. But then he never allowed me. Then after few days, shayad unko hi thoda bura laga kya rahi hai, roj bol rahi hai. So he got a racket for me, like some old racket, smaller ones, jo kids ka milta hai wo. So he got a old racket for me, gave me a shuttle and he was like, do wall practice. Then first I was like, what is wall practice? Then he was like, you have to just play with the wall. And once you start playing with the wall, then you have to hit continuous 100 shuttle, like without dropping a shuttle. So I started doing it. It took me more than a month, but then I started doing it. And after I finished 100, I was like, sir, ho gaya ab. Like, I used to call him Abba. So I was like, Abba, zhala me shambhar kele and all. Then he didn't show me any interest. He's like, abhi 500 karna hai fir court mein. Isa karke, he asked me to 1,000. Matlab, 1,000 mujhse complete nahi huye the, but I completed around 800, 900. And then after that, he like allowed me to play on court. So... वो ऐसा मतलब इजीली कुछ नहीं मिलेगा ही taught me that from very beginning.
Sure. So sir, Yogita, how was the formal training then? How did your coaching start? What was your schedule?
Like when I was
during those days, yes. Okay. When you started.
Those days I used to train in the morning, like 6 o'clock, ground training. So I used to train with all the senior kids and stuff. So it was pretty tough for me before, but then I was like hyperactive and aisa hamesha, like I can't sit for more than 10-15 minutes in one place. So it was not very tough for me, but yeah, to maintain their their level, yeah, it was tough for me. But then later, like after like 6 months and all, I was completely into it, and I used to look forward ke nahi abhi kal uth ke mere ko ek ghanta bhagna hai and mujhe 100 push-ups karne hai. In that age, like even when I was 10 and all, I used to do 100 push-ups and stuff. So बीच में स्कूल रहता था, सो आई यूज्ड टू गो टू द स्कूल एंड वंस आई कम बैक फ्रॉम स्कूल आई यूज्ड टू ईट, आई यूज्ड टू स्लीप फॉर एन आवर और समथिंग एंड देन गो ट्रेन अगेन ऑन कोर्ट फॉर 3 hours.
सो इवन देन यू हैड 2 सेशंस.
या सो आई यूज्ड टू ट्रेन इन द मॉर्निंग लाइक फिजिकल ट्रेनिंग एंड देन ऑन कोर्ट इन द इवनिंग.
ओके. So when was the thought of taking it professionally, or was it from the onset that this is what I want to do?
No, not actually. Before, as in, I was into, I used to play a lot of sports. Even in school, I used to play kho-kho, hockey, and I was in all the teams. Like, I represented my school in almost every sport.
Okay.
I was also good at running. So, and also I was in district team for kho-kho and hockey. So, like before, my parents were not very keen about like sirf badminton hi karna hai and all. But then there was my first tournament, state tournament, which I won.
Okay.
So after that, even my coach was like very happy with me, and he insisted my parents like she should take it as a profession, and because I was doing good, and so even my parents thought of putting me into badminton like completely, and even my school supported me a lot even in that age.
So that was under 13, the state tournament,
under
or 10. Under 10. Oh, that was under 10. Okay.
I was something 8 or 9 year old, I think that.
So do you remember your very first tournament?
Yeah, I completely remember. But I don't remember whom I played my finals. I think I played with Shruti Mundada. I don't remember exactly. But then that time it was like old scoring system.
15 points.
Yeah. For girls it was 11 points.
11 points, yeah.
15 points. So, yeah, I remember I won my first final, state final that time. And also after that, my first under 10 nationals, I played finals.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's good.
I remember that match, like every day, like I was just 9 and a half, and every day morning, like from qualifying I played, and from qualifying it was like first match I remember qualifying first round. So my mom dad were with me. I was playing that tournament in Bangalore, and subah utke my mom was like, "Kya, what you want for breakfast?" I'm like, "Kuch bhi chalega." So she got idli, and I won my match. So every day till finals, I ate only idli before match.
So you were so superstitious back then.
Yeah, kind of. But then every match, like even in the morning or afternoon or night, whatever my match timings were, before 1 hour, I used to eat idli and I used to go for my match.
That's a good secret. So Sayogita, after you won your first state, which was under 10, you shifted brace from Kolhapur to Pune. So Pune, obviously, it's a big setup.
No, actually, I shifted when I was under 13.
Okay.
Yeah, and till then, I had already played under 13. I was in the state team when I was in Kolhapur.
Okay.
Yeah, so training in Kolhapur itself, I got into the state team and I had represented Maharashtra at Chandigarh Nationals. I remember that was my first Nationals. And even my brother was there in under-16 team. So we both of ours first Nationals was Chandigarh.
That's good.
Yeah, like so, first time we got all the Yonex kitting and stuff. It was nice. Really.
So why was the decision to shift from Kolhapur to Pune?
We actually shifted for like everything, like for my brother's education, like he wanted to do engineering and stuff. So for him, and even my dad has got his own business. So it was important for him as well to shift to Pune, because half of the time he was traveling, like within a week, he was four times traveling to Pune and then to Kolhapur, like up down he used to do ek ek din ka. So it was pretty tough for him. So sabka dekh ke we got shifted to Pune.
Okay, but Sayogita, shifting from Kolhapur to Pune was even a big shift in terms of badminton, because Pune has a rich culture of badminton. They have huge academies, but probably I think Kolhapur didn't had that big academy. How difficult was it for you in the change of environment?
Before it was difficult, like initial stages when I came, for kyunki kaise hota hai ki like a big place and big cities, and you're coming from a small town, and suddenly like I say, there are people who are like ki are iska language kaisa hai. Like I used to speak like thoda Kolhapuri mara, so they were like ki thoda sa aisa sideline kiya jata hai na. So it was kind of difficult, because I was a kid. So we used to give more importance ki log kya sochte hai, and they are not talking to me or something like that. So somewhere mera thoda sa confidence level kam hua tha when I came here, because few people used to make fun of me like on my face, saying ki are no manai to na nahi.
Okay.
Yeah, so like puneri marathi type. So thoda sa who are difficult. But then later, game wise, I won my first Pune district state, which I played in Pune. Jo pehle saal I won that not state, the district
tournament.
So yeah, I got into the academy, like in PDMBA, and was training under Archana Devdhar that time.
So how did it change after you won the district tournament? In terms of the people,
like
the
people
way they
started recognizing me, and they started talking to me, and tabhi matlab it's like your racket speaks, as I said before. So itna zyada difficulty nahi hua baad mein, because everybody was like, okay, we want to be friends with her and she's doing good in the game. So that time it doesn't matter, like ki meeno munte ka no.
True. It's only your performance that talks.
Yeah.
So Sayogita, how was the journey from there on? So how you progressed from a player who is playing states, nationals, and a professional player? So how was the transition for you?
Transition as in when I started, like at my very little age. So that time I never knew I would go this far, But then because of my first coach, he always taught me that you won't get anything easily. You have to fight for it. Like chote chote cheezo se bhi. Because like whenever I used to play or something, go for a tournament or something like that, he used to give me small challenges ki, okay, this tournament you have to beat this player, or this tournament, at least if not beat, at least you have to make this much score against her or something like that, like small challenges. So I started looking for it, like every time I entered the court, that I have to face some challenge. I won't get it easily. Then I made my mindset was like that since my childhood, that I won't get anything easily. So it made easier, like I didn't have to face a lot of like matlab aisa zyada kuch changes nahi hue when I was transiting ki ye stage se ye stage, ye stage se ye stage. It just went on happening and I kept believing in myself and the things were like falling in place.
So you said when you came to Pune, you were playing with a new coach. So yeah. Then as you were progressing in terms of performance, did you shift academies within Pune or you stuck to the same?
I changed academies within Pune. I changed thrice. I started playing with Archana Devdhar. Then I shifted to Ravi Kunte sir. For a few years, I trained with him. And then I shifted to Varun Khanwalkar. So I trained with him for 2 years and then I shifted to Hyderabad, at Gopichand Academy. I was in the camp, so I got shifted. Yeah.
So how's the overall experience of getting into Gopichand Academy in the national camp? So tell us more about it.
Actually, when I went there, I was not in a good mindset because of the tragedy that happened. Like I lost my elder brother in a car accident. So it was pretty difficult for me to leave my parents and go there. But then when I went there, I like Gopichand sir, he first told me that you should be here and you come for like a week or two and then see if you are like liking the atmosphere here, then you can play here, or else you can just go back. Then I just went with a small bag that I just have to stay for a week.
Mm-hmm.
Or a week or something like that, and I was not sure if I will be able to stay there. So I went, and jitna bag leke gayi thi, wo sare kapde ek din mein lage mujhe. So I was borrowing clothes from like a Pradnya, Arundhati, everybody was training there since years. So I used to borrow clothes, and I stayed there for a month or two. I trained there, and actually everybody, like all seniors and everybody, was really supportive, and I was traveling for tournaments with them itself, and I was getting a good there was lot to learn. Like looking at the players, other players, all the top players training under one roof, and how they are off court, how they are on court, how they are managing their diet, everything, like mental state, diet, everything. So it was good to be around such people, such competitive playing people. So it was nice. Overall, it was a nice experience.
So you have played in Pune with some of the biggest coaches and players. So Ravi Kunte, he's Asian championship. He has represented India in Asian championship. So how different do players train in Gopichand Academy, and what is it that it graduates them to a different level? So are there any secret training, which is the usual perception that
secret training as of? The thing is, the atmosphere there is so good. Like from morning to night, you are only thinking about the game. Like utne ke baad, you have to be ready. You have to be on the court. Then come out, eat whatever diet you are being referred to. You have to eat everything, like nutrition food and everything. And then later again, take rest, then go back to the center. Like we used to stay in the center itself, go back to the court, then gym. Everything was in under one roof. So here what happens, like you have to stay home. Then other things are also there to distract you. like I used to stay like 20 kilometers away from my playing place, and I used to travel by PMT, like bus. So the thing is, I couldn't focus that much when I'm on court because I'm already little drained by traveling and stuff, like carrying all the way by PMT and stuff. So it was pretty difficult here to train as much as I was training. Like I could save that energy and use it on court instead there when I'm not traveling. So it was easier for me to focus more when I was there. And here, like, parents' mentality is not like ki completely you have to be in badminton, ki studies bhi hai, ye bhi hai, wo bhi hai. So even when the players were coming here, like when I was training in Pune, like their mindset is not completely like ki haan, mujhe badminton khelna hai. They are like, okay, abhi 2 ghanta khelna hai, and then completely off. And then they are into some completely different life. Like some people today don't even know ki they are a badminton player.
Correct.
They are completely cut off. So this won't happen when you are training at the National Training Center. And looking at all the senior players like Saina, Sindhu, or Kashyap, Srikanth, Pranoy, everybody, the kind of efforts they put every time they step on the court, it's like you have so much to learn only looking at them. So you have such great players playing over there, and you are getting to share the court with them, so that matters. Like here I won't get such players playing at that level to train with.
True. So do you remember any piece of advice which probably Saina, Sindhu, or Kashyap gave you at some point of time, and it really helped you?
Yeah, actually, I remember Kashyap's. Even he lost his elder sister. So when I went there, I had lost my elder brother. So he told me, like, once I remember, I spoke to him about it, like, how do you deal with these things? Like, I know it's pretty difficult to get over these things. But then he was like, that's life. That's life. And you have to keep moving. Like, your life won't stop for anybody else. So you have to accept whatever has happened to you and move on. So that really helped me, like in everything. You can take anything, like maybe injuries or anything. Okay, it's happened. So you can't be crying over what's happened in past. You have to be really keen over what you want in life and what you need to do more, like what work you have to do more to get over the things.
So, so Yogita, how the year 2012 changed your life? Because I know Siddhant was a very good friend of mine as well. We had played a few tournaments. Obviously, he was elder to me. But you had mentioned me that you were also about to, you also faced an accident, met with an accident after that. So how were you in terms of your mental space post his accident?
Actually, I was completely shocked, like when it actually happened that day. I was like completely in shock. I still remember I didn't cry for like 3 or 4 days, and few people, like there were some doctors and stuff, so they were like saying that she needs to cry, like she needs to take it out or else it will be really difficult if she goes in depression or something like that. So I remember some uncle, he started talking to me, he came to me and he's like, ki, tula kaya aathavta tacha baddal and all. That's how I started talking, ki I miss him, ye karte, because we used to share the same room and everything, like even I used to share his clothes and everything. So it's like, sab jage saath mein jaate the, training karne saath mein. So sab aadat ho gayi thi uski, pura time. So I never imagined my life without him, and suddenly this thing happened. So it was like it completely changed my life. So like I was completely alone. I didn't know what to do. Like even practice ko jaate time I used to sit behind him on the bike and go. So I didn't know ki main karu kya abhi. And even he taught me how to hold a racket. So it all started from there, and I was even scared to hold the racket. Like after his death, when I first entered the court, I couldn't hold the racket. Matlab wo bachpan ka yaad aa raha tha ki how he taught me and how we used to play and stuff. So it was very difficult. Like slowly.
Yes, and I think that was the point when you decided not to play in Pune and to go to Hyderabad.
So
coming back to the Hyderabad thing, so how was your schedule there?
There, when I first went, I used to train in the morning. 4:30 my session used to start, first session. So I used to wake up around 4:15, and 4:30 to 5:36 first session, then 8:30 to 11 next session, and again 3 to 5 or something like that. Last session 3 to 5 or 4 to 6, and then we were given some extra time to do some light skills like service practice and some standing stuff if you want to do the receiving and stuff. So I used to do that after 7 to 8 or something.
Sayugata, I want to ask you one thing. I spoke to many players. I spoke to Saili, even Mansi Joshi was in the shows, Aparna Balan. Everyone had different views regarding Gopichand Academy. Some had good views, some had, you know, didn't get that kind of a treatment which they wanted. So what is your take? You also had mixed observations or mixed experiences.
Lot of mixed experiences. It's okay, as in you have a lot of ups and downs and stuff. So I had already gone through a lot, and then sub academies mein favoritism to hota hai, like it happens. So I did face some of that, like not being the favorite ones.
Sure.
So yeah, it was pretty difficult. Thoda beech mein I used to lose my mind or something like that, but then I used to cope up ki, okay, if this is it, then I have to go ahead with it. Like there's no stopping, because I want to play, and so nobody else can tell me like who I'll be or who I am right now.
So in 2015 you've had a career threatening injury. So walk us through that particular incident. How did it happen? What were you preparing for that time?
I was playing national games. Mixed doubles. I was playing. Me and Shlok were playing against, I think, I don't remember who against we were playing. But then we were playing our quarterfinals, and I twisted my right knee.
Okay.
So I got a ACL tear. It was a complete tear. Complete rupture. So I had to go through a surgery, and it took me 9 months to get back on court. So I got operated in Jan or Feb 2015. I got operated, and I started playing in October.
Okay.
Yeah, 8 months.
And again, when you came back on court, again, you got injured. And this time it was the other leg, I think?
Yeah, other leg, Achilles tendon.
Okay.
Like, complete rupture.
So again, 8 months of break?
No, 11 months of break. Like I started training in October. And October, November, December, I played. And within three months, I played. I had one All India title. I had two bronze All India medals, and also semi-finalist at the Bangladesh International Challenge. So even there was bronze. And I remember, like, I played Bareilly finals in December 31st. I played my finals. I won that match, and I came back home. and I was training at Balewadi, and my Achilles tendon snapped like thak karke, aawaz aaya zor se, and the one I was playing with, she was like, कुछ टूटा कोर्ट में, कुछ टूटा. आई वाज लाइक कोर्ट में नहीं, मेरे पैर में टूटा. लाइक इतना जोर से आवाज हुआ था व्हेन इट स्नैप्ड एंड इट वाज बैड. लाइक आई हैव शेयर्ड माय पिक्चर, वो स्नैप हुआ हुआ ऑन इंस्टाग्राम, यू कैन चेक इट.
ओके. बट व्हेन यू केम बैक पोस्ट दैट इंजरी, यू देन प्रोबेबली पीक्ड इन योर बैडमिंटन करियर. सो वॉक अस थ्रू दैट, all that journey.
When I got operated for my Achilles tendon, I decided that I'm not going to play and I'm quitting badminton. But then there was, like I told you about the incidents. So yes. You want me to talk about
it? Yes, for sure. I want you to talk about all the incidents.
Okay, so there was a coach, so I am not going to name him, but then the national coach, you can say, not national coach, but yeah. So when I went to Hyderabad for my rehab, just to check my situation for my Achilles tendon and for the advanced rehab, I went there after 5 or 6 months. I was still struggling to walk, because I had a lot of stitches and it didn't heal properly. So that time I decided that I'll stop playing. But then I at least wanted to walk properly or run or something of that sort. Even if I don't play badminton, me being a fitness freak, I wanted to do something related to sport, but then completely quit badminton. So I just went there to just get a checkup, and when I entered, that coach was like, you better stop playing badminton, you're not meant for badminton. And within that 6 months, I had done few shoots, like photo shoots and like gym shoots and stuff. So he had seen it on Facebook and he was like, you are good at modeling, so you better do that and not come back here. Do not come back here, he said that. So till that time, I was very keen on my decision that I'm not going to play badminton. But then when he said that, isa matlab wo khoon khol uthta hai na, aisa hua na mujhe ki, who is he to tell me what I should do? So later, like today, I want to thank him for saying that to me. Matlab wo us din khelta nahi, bolta nahi, to today I would have quitted badminton completely. Because he said that, and I have this ziddi wala nature ki aise koi bola na, chal main abhi dikhati usko, aise bola na isne mere ko. So I have that in me, like since childhood. So very stubborn nature. So maine usko bola ki, I'll come back, I'll play. Like I thought I'll quit badminton, but I need to prove a lot of people that what I can do. And I'll come back and I'll show you what I can do. So that night itself, I went back to Pune and I started doing my rehab. Like even raat ko 2-3 baje bhi room ke baju mein push-ups se wo ke matlab, okay, my lower body is injured, I can at least train my upper body. So aisa towel wagera door ko laga ke, I have to close the door and then it fixes na. So usme pull-ups and all, I used to do insane workout. Like I had got dumbbells and everything in my house, and I used to train whenever I used to get time, like abs and everything. So in November, I remember I started playing back, and first nationals I was not getting the entry because I didn't play for the whole year. So Air India, I didn't get entry from Air India. Also Air India kicked me out because I was injured back to back, like 2 years were wasted, and they wanted to take some new player, so they kicked me off. And I represented Maharashtra and partnered Shikha. Like she used to play only singles that time, and we got wildcard entry in Patna Nationals, and and I was the runner-up there, and I felt so proud of myself that day. I mean, I was standing on the podium and I felt so good. And वो कोच का ही चेहरा आ रहा था, मतलब मुझे बुरा नहीं लग रहा था, मुझे कुछ गुस्सा नहीं आ रहा था, but then मुझे ऐसे I wanted to thank him that day, call करके कि मतलब तू उस दिन वो बोला नहीं होता ना तो मैं आज बेड में पड़े ही सो ही रहती.
True. And again, there was a phase which came in your life that was in, I think, 2018 Nagpur Nationals.
Yeah.
So after every up, there has to be a down in your career. So yes. Walk us through that tournament. How was it?
Yeah. So after my Nagpur Nationals, we were playing pretty good. Then I partnered Prajakta. Then we were really good. Like I was at the peak of my career, like 2018, 2019, like. From 2017, it was like really good. तो मुझे मतलब ऐसा लग रहा था कि okay, there's no stopping now and I have to like just play and get medals for the country. That's it. Like every day, I used to sleep with that thing in my mind कि हाँ अभी कल उठ के ये training करना इधर इधर ये. Like I was completely into it and I was enjoying it. So before Nagpur Nationals, we were training at Malaysia. So while training, like while sprinting, I had a pull in my hamstring, like in my right hamstring. So I rested for a few days and then I went for Egypt tournament, Egypt International. And while playing finals, I got very bad cramps and then I think it, that pull, jo pull hua tha, I torn or something like that happened and I had a tear in my hamstring. So I came back and I came back to Pune. I did MRI and everything and there was like 1.5 centimeter ka tear and all. And within 5 days, I had Nagpur Nationals. Hmm. So doctor asked me that you can't play or else that hamstring will completely tear off. And then you have to go through one more surgery. Then I was like, shit, no. And directly, like, when I left from hospital, I sent a withdrawal mail to Air India that I'm not playing.
Okay.
I'm not playing this nationals. I don't want to go through one more surgery. And that's enough. I'm taking a break. Then Prajakta and the manager from Air India, they asked me, ki, matlab, let's see how the draw goes and then you can then decide like if you want to play, if you want to quit or anything. So I was like, okay. So unhone withdrawal hold pe rakha and Prajakta reached Nagpur. I was still home thinking ki jau ki nahi jau because I was really scared ki matlab wapas surgery hua to I won't be able to take that pain and stuff. So but still somehow we managed and I went there and managers meeting hua, draws were out and we got pretty easy draw. So like easy draw maybe first round we played 3 games.
Hmm.
So aisa matlab limb karte karte khela and then we reached quarterfinals and then super draw wagera tha, then we played Purvisha and Meghna in quarters. Hmm. And also I was playing mixed doubles that tournament. Like aisa limb karte karte me and Sayam, like Sayam was playing everywhere. I was like Sayam. Sayam was running everywhere. He was taking my shuttles, his own shuttles, everything. And like I'm damn sure Prajakta or Sayam ke liye wo tournament sabse tough gaya hoga meri wajah se. So we like both events I played quarterfinals and both events I won quarterfinals and in quarterfinals like third game we were trailing 11-3 and from there we won 21-19. So and we played a match like a 1 hour ka match and usse pehle I played mixed doubles as well which I won. So it was like really tiring day and morning like I played three quarters and evening quarterfinals like that. And four matches I played in a day, one ghante ka, and I was like really exhausted. And I came out, I was just stretching, and I got cramps like in my whole body. I got cramps, and I was like on the stretcher very next minute, and I was admitted. Like I had semifinals next day morning, and I was admitted. I was actually with the drip. I was sleeping on the hospital bed, and I was like. like my mom and dad were like, okay, we are going back to Pune. No more of badminton for you. We are going back to Pune and let's just stop all this, and we can't see you in such a situation. So let's go back. My dad though started looking for
tickets.
Make my trip khol ke aur ticket aur aaj raat ka hi hai ki aaj raat hi chale jate hai and all. So I requested that doctor ki please ek match khelne do, please ek match. I'll Sayam was like, we'll not play mixed doubles. So I can't go and concede because I can't play my doubles match then. So Sayam was like, anyways, we are playing against Ashwini and Satwik. So it will be difficult for you to play two matches back to back. So better we concede this match, and I'll tell referee that he has got the injury. So I said, okay, fine. Then from hospital, they discharged me, and then I went back to the room. I slept for some time. Then morning, I took my medicines, drape laga ke sab, I went for my match. So mixed doubles, we considered. Then I had my doubles match. After Sindhu's and Saina's match, we had our doubles. So beech mein kaafi time mila. So even in that time, I was taking all the glucose and everything. So semi-finals, we won third game 15.
Okay.
Doubles, me and Prajakta. And then we were finally into finals, and I was like very happy. Ki, matlab, 5 days pehle, I was not ready to get out of my bed, and now I'm playing finals with this leg. Like, it was like...
believable, true.
Yeah, it was unbelievable. So... it was a great experience. So after that, we lost in finals. Like, we played against Ashwini and Sikki. So it was pretty difficult to play against them in that situation. So we lost against them. But then because of that tournament, we got into all the teams. Like, we were in the Uber Cup team. We played Asia Team Championship. We were in the team for Asian Championships. Then we got qualified for World Championships. So everything, like, I was on my peak and very happy.
But Sayogita, as we are speaking now, obviously we are joking and we are laughing about that phase of yours. But when you were actually there, that must be very difficult years or months for you. Getting injured and then that recovery phase, again getting back on the court. Because your competitors, while you are resting, your competitors are still training hard. So how difficult was it for you physically as well as mentally to get on the court and deal with that phase?
Like I told you, I had a very stubborn nature. So when I decided ki I wanted to do it, like, I'll do anything to get it. So because of that, it made things easier for me. Yes, mentally it was pretty difficult. Sometimes I used to lose my mindset. I used to cry to myself. I used to cry. There were nights when I used to cry every single night. But then again, I used to make sure that morning I'm going and training. So that really helped me to become fit mentally as well as physically. So I also faced depression. I was on the pills for a few weeks, but then I realized that I'm not that weak to be so much dependent on the pills and stuff. But the situation was so bad, so that time I took pills, but then later I was completely on my own selves. I used to see inspirational videos, I used to talk to the people, and whatever I was feeling, I had my parents support mainly. I had a lot of support from my parents. So it really helped me to get through the phase.
So, Sayogita, you said you were in depression and you used to take pills. So when was the moment you found out that, okay, it means this is something which is affecting me? And whom did you open up first? I am asking this because we had Gayatri Vartak on our talk. She said that discussing mental health is like the person has gone mad. You know, this is the general perception.
I know.
So how was it for you opening up to people?
So There's one of my relative who's into prana, like yoga, meditation and everything, and she's also she has also done PhD in homeopathy and stuff. So I went to her and I spoke everything to her and I cried, and like they have that thing in them na, like ki sab bol ke wo nikalte hai ki kya feel ho raha actually. So she actually made me like anything that day. She was like ki nahi mujhe aur bata, like what you feel. So I started talking to her, and then it was pretty difficult for me to open up at first. It took me like 3-4 sessions to open up completely and talk whatever I was feeling. May it be my personal life, may it be my professional life, everything. So also after I lost my brother, I had developed this like insecurities of losing people. So I like whenever I used to talk to someone, I had to keep in mind ki matlab nahi isse zyada baat nahi karni hai kyunki he'll leave me. So okay. I had developed that thing, and then I got to know that thing after I spoke to my therapist. That I have developed such things, and fear of performance and fear of getting injured again. So this thing actually I faced after my third injury, like third surgery. After I played like everything, I had a real good year in 2018. I was also in the PBL team, Awadh Warriors. And then I was supposed to travel on 20th, and 19th I got operated. So yeah, so while playing All India tournament, I twisted my left knee. So after that surgery, it was really difficult for me to get back on court. And like when I started talking to my therapist, like it was pretty difficult to open up, because first of all, I was in such a mindset that I didn't wanted to talk to someone. Like I just wanted to be alone. I just wanted to be in my own space. Like even in my house, I used to lock my door and just sit inside doing nothing, like just staring somewhere and just sitting for hours. So yeah, I faced that thing, and it was pretty difficult to get out of it. But then I had this sudden realization ki nahi, I'm not this type of a person. I can't be crying aise baith ke. And you know, as a sportsman's life is very little, like you can't be playing competitive till you are old or something like that. So seniors mein you can play till 32-35 max. And you have to then get back to your own life. Like you can play after that, but then veterans and all, like
correct,
maintaining your family and stuff. So I was like, this is the time. I don't have anything else to cry over, and like I'm just overthinking about it. And agar do surgeries se I have come out, then why not the third one? Do surgeries se bahar aake, when I actually thought of quitting badminton, I was at the peak of my game. So if I have done it twice, why not one more time? Just give it a try. And that's how I used to talking to yourself when you feel upset, it's most important. Like I was looking for inspiration, motivation outside me, but I had forgotten that there's so much inspiration like inside me. Like people are looking towards me for to gain some inspiration. Like I get a lot of messages on Instagram and Facebook saying that you are the inspiration for us, you have come through all of this. So this makes me feel so good about my own self that I have nothing to lose, and I can only get through all this and inspire more people every single day. Like if I quit everything and start crying over things like ye hua, that's not me. And I have to get over all this and I have to fight back.
True. And also, Sayogita, one thing which I want to ask you is, there was one particular match. Obviously, you lost that match, but after that, you met the same coach which had told you that you are not meant for badminton. He came to you and he praised you and he apologized. So yeah. Tell us about that particular incident.
Actually, the same coach who asked me to quit badminton, so he traveled with us for one tournament and it was a team event. And he didn't he was completely against me. मतलब वो badminton player में मुझे गिनता ही नहीं था. Like he said it कि you are not meant for badminton. So he actually meant it and he was behaving like that I'm not meant for badminton. Even if I'm traveling with them, with the Indian team, still I'm not the part of the Indian team for him. I'm just one person traveling with them. That's it. So we had a match. This thing, I think, ek saal tak he didn't believe in me or any, like he just hated me. He didn't look at me as a good player. He just thought ki haan, khelti hai bas, aisa. Like he never took me seriously. So I went for a tournament and it happened that he was the coach for the team. And I was traveling with him for the first time. And he never used to, like, he used to say good morning and good night and like hi, hello to all the players. But he used to just like, मैं उसके लिए इनविजिबल हूँ, मैं दिखती नहीं थी उसको. वो मेरे ऊपर से या मेरे अंदर से देखता था. सो आई वॉज दैट इनविजिबल फॉर हिम. एंड वी हैड आवर फर्स्ट मैच अगेंस्ट हांगकॉन्ग एंड देन we went for practice and stuff. So he didn't let me practice. He was like, तू जाके कुछ तो training कर. He didn't even allow me to play. So first match, tie में मेरा नाम ही नहीं है. He made singles players play doubles because of lack of confidence in me. Mm-hmm. So instead of me, my partner played doubles with some other singles player, and then we won that tie and stuff. So it's a round robin tha. Like there were groups A, B, C, D, and we had Hong Kong, China, India, and Japan in one tie.
Which tournament was this?
This was Asia Team Championship.
Okay. So
first tie to we won and we were already into quarterfinals because Japan will obviously beat Hong Kong, China. So two teams were supposed to go forward and then we were like, okay, ab to ho gaya, we are going to the quarters. So we were playing against Japan and Japan's team was like really good and sub world champions and sub, and we had all junior players wagera in the team. Saina didn't come. Sindhu was there. Then Sikki Ashwini, like only seniors, and all others were like junior players. So we had to play Japan next, and the tie was yet to decide. And then that coach was like, okay, ye kuch important tie nahi hai na, we'll make Sanyogita play. Itna okay. Casually bola na ki matlab, मुझे ऐसा लगा ना कि क्या यार कचरा ही बना दिया मेरे को. बट देन आई वॉज हैप्पी इनसाइड कि एटलीस्ट आई एम गेटिंग अ चांस टू प्ले टू प्रूव. सो वी प्लेड अगेंस्ट वर्ल्ड नंबर 6 जापानीज पेयर एंड आवर स्कोर वॉज 18-19 समथिंग लाइक दैट 21-18 21-19 वी लॉस्ट. एंड आई केम आउटसाइड आई सैट बिसाइड्स हिम कि ठीक है बाबा ये मुझे हेट करता है लेकिन he's the coach and he knows better than me ki bahar se dikhta hai what I played and I should at least take some tips from him so that I can improve. So I kept everything aside and just went, I sat beside him and I asked him ki coach, what do you think, how did I play and how was your what are your views over my game. So first of all he just looked at me and he was like, I never thought ki you would even make 6 points against them. And 6 points kaise dono game mila ke.
Because they were world number 6.
Yeah, so he thought that both games ka total score 6 wagera hoga, aisa usko laga tha. And you played incredibly well, and I was like very happy रे, मतलब ऐसा ये अच्छा कैसा बात कर रहा है मेरे साथ. मुझे ऐसा अंदर से ऐसा थोड़ा सा ऐसा हो रहा था कि मैं थक के आई थी, कुछ लग ही नहीं रहा था. I was like very happy कि ये मेरे से अच्छे से बात कर रहा है. And he's praising me and inside मेरे कुछ मतलब अलग ही मैं सोच रही हूँ कि मतलब ये बात कैसे कर रहा है and all ऐसा, मतलब game वेम का साइड में ही रह गया. So then he said that I'm happy that Indian badminton is in good hands. Women's doubles Indian badminton is in good hands. And I started crying in front of him. Like actually I started crying in front of him. And he was like, I'm sorry. I treated you really bad. And I never thought that you would do this good in badminton. But now I would say that... you are really a talented player, really hardworking, and you deserve much more than this. And I was like on cloud nine. मतलब ऐसे समझ में ही नहीं आ रहा था मैं क्या करूँ. I was so happy. And then quarterfinals, when he was writing a tie, I still didn't expect कि मतलब ठीक है उसने मेरे लिए अच्छा वगैरह बोला ठीक है, लेकिन I didn't expect कि वो मुझे खिलाएगा because quarterfinals है. But then he made me and Sindhu play doubles. So we were playing against Indonesia. We lost that match, but then we played well. और ऐसा मतलब वो इतना अच्छा experience था ना मेरा. Like मैं गई tournament के लिए कुछ अलग mindset से कि यार ये coach आ रहा है, मतलब मैं पूरी ऐसे मतलब मुझे नहीं पता है कैसे जाएगा tournament. I was really upset while traveling to Malaysia. But then while coming back, I was on some other trip. मतलब ऐसा अपने आप में खुश की मतलब कितना कुछ मैंने पा लिया ऐसा लग रहा था. लाइक आई सेड रैकेट स्पीक.
ट्रू.
सो इट वाज रियली नाइस एक्सपीरियंस.
सो संयोगिता, वी हैव फ्यू क्वेश्चंस फॉर यू. सो वन इज फ्रॉम अविनाश. ही सेज दैट यू हैड एसीएल सर्जरी एंड रिहैबिलिटेशन इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट एलिमेंट. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ एक्सरसाइजेस हेल्प्ड यू ओवरकम दिस इंजरी?
Okay, so hi Avinash. First of all, prehab is also important. Like if you have faced ACL tear or something like that, you should do your prehab, like which we do before surgery. So it will help you to get the muscle strength and also the flexibility back after the surgery, which is most important. So once your surgery is done, you have to be very much into your rehab, and you have to do it. Like even if doctor says that you have to do it once or twice, then you have to do it thrice or four times a day. Like whatever, whenever you feel you start doing your bending and stuff, because bending is very painful after the ACL surgery. So once you get the full range and once you start sitting in Vajrasana and everything, you can start with the strength training. And before going on court, it's very much important that you gain strength and both your legs are of same size, and so that you don't get injured again. And in rehab, there are a lot of exercises, but then it will be better if you talk to your physio or your doctor about it, because telling over a phone won't be of much help to you. And if it's possible for me, I'll surely post a video about the rehab exercises which I do, like advanced rehab for my knee right now. So I can post the video on my Instagram or my Facebook. If you are following me there, you can check it out.
That would be wonderful, Sayogita. If you share, even I can share those videos. That will certainly help. So there's one question coming from Prakash. He asks, how important is coach's role in a setup where all the players are playing at national or international level?
Coach's role actually is the most important, because every single day you are working under him, you are working with him. How he treats you, how much attention you are getting. So everything is important, not just on court, off court as well. Like whatever you are doing, it should be related to badminton when you are completely into it. लाइक इट्स नॉट लाइक कि हाँ मतलब सिर्फ ऑन कोर्ट कोच है ना वो उतना उतना देख लेगा, बट ही हैज टू लुक आफ्टर एवरीथिंग. लाइक इफ यू आर रेस्टिंग वेल, ही नीड्स टू नो यू इन एंड आउट, लाइक एवरीथिंग. लाइक वेन एवर यू आर टायर्ड, यू एंड यू आर नॉट टेलिंग और यू आर नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑन योर ओन सेल्फ दैट यू आर वेरी टायर्ड टू ट्रेन, एंड इफ यू ट्रेन इन दैट माइंड सेट यू माइट गेट इंजर्ड. सो इट्स इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर योर कोच टू नो यू इन एंड आउट.
There's another question coming from Praveen Chane. He asks, how can Indians reach the international level of ladies doubles?
Okay, so now everybody is doing really good, and like even women's doubles are coming up with good players now. They are, before what has to happen that everybody was just concentrating on singles, but after after Jwala, Ashwini and Sikki, everybody started looking forward for doubles as well. Even Chirag Satwik is doing well. So doubles is given some platform in India now. So slowly, slowly, we are hoping to get good results in women doubles as well.
Apart from questions, Sayogita, there have been a lot of wishes for you. Very inspiring journey of Sayogita. Kudos to the brave and strong girl. And all the best for your future endeavors. So all messages are coming. There are at least 10 to 15 messages.
Oh, thank you so much, everyone.
You are a mentally strong girl. All the messages are coming. So there is one question, Sayogita, from Sanvi. She asks, what kept you motivated during your injury period?
Yeah, that's most important. Like if you keep crying over the thing, ki ye hua, ye hua, ye hua, if you keep thinking negative, it won't take you anywhere. You have to distract yourself. So when I was injured, I didn't get time to paint or to spend time with my family or sleep whenever I want. I just love to sleep. Matlab aise late ki so gayi. So I never used to get so much of time for my own self. So I started doing whatever I like to do or I love to do. So I get lot of I got lot of time for myself, and I also did some photo shoots. I like बचपन से मैं पापा को बोलती थी मुझे एक्टिंग में जाना है ये वो. सो आई स्टार्टेड एटलीस्ट नॉट एक्टिंग बट समथिंग ऑफ दैट सॉर्ट. सो आई स्टार्टेड डूइंग सम शूट्स, आई डिड सम रैंप वॉक एंड शोज एंड स्टफ. सो इट वाज रियली नाइस. लाइक आई कंप्लीटली लिव्ड सम डिफरेंट लाइफ एंड आई वाज अ कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट पर्सन. बट देन आई न्यू वेयर टू स्टॉप एंड वेयर टू गेट बैक ऑन कोर्ट विदाउट गेटिंग डिस्ट्रैक्टेड.
So one last question from Avinash. Even I wanted to ask you the same question. He asks, you are mentally strong as you have gone through difficult circumstances in your early life. Does this help you to cope up with the failures as well?
Yeah, a lot. As in, sometimes it happens. Like in sports, it's part and parcel of life. Like you have to face failures. Aisa बहुत कम होते. लाइक सिंधु साइना, दे हैव ओनली फेस्ड कि मतलब अरे सब जीता है. लाइक दे हैव गॉट लॉट ऑफ, बट सब नहीं, सब सिंधु साइना जैसे नहीं हो सकते. देर आर लॉट ऑफ प्लेयर्स हु आर फेसिंग फेलियर्स बट स्टिल दे आर लाइक दे आर गेटिंग बैक एट इट. वो एवरीबडी हैज देयर ओन स्टोरी. लाइक ऐसे नहीं है कि ठीक है अभी नहीं हो रहा है ना, एक बार हार गए तो छोड़ दिया. यू हैव टू कीप गोइंग एंड इफ यू हैव दैट पैशन फॉर योर गेम, दैट अनकंडीशनल लव फॉर योर गेम, इफ यू रिस्पेक्ट योर गेम दैट मच, यू विल गेट बैक एट इट. लाइक वॉट एवर फेलियर्स यू फेस, लाइक एंड इट्स इम्पोर्टेंट टू फेस फेलियर्स, ओनली देन यू विल बी एबल टू टेस्ट द सक्सेस.
So Yogita, if you had to tell something to your younger self, what would it be?
Yeah, so basically when I was young, I used to overthink a lot. Matlab, ki matlab ye kya sochega, wo kya sochega. So I just want to tell my own self that believe in yourself and keep moving ahead. Like everyone else will follow you. And जो कुछ नहीं आ रहा है ना वो छोड़ना चाहिए. लाइक यू डोंट हैव टू केयर अबाउट एनीबडी, एनीवन, in your life. You have to just think about yourself. It might sound a bit selfish, but then yeah, it's life. And then you know, like childhood se bahut kam log rahenge jo leaving your parents or your family, bahut kam log rahenge who are still with you.
True.
So I have faced a lot of things now, like whenever I'm at my peak, I'm surrounded by people, and whenever I'm injured, I have no people around. So it doesn't matter to me right now. Like, so I just want to tell my younger self that believe in yourself and you are enough for your own self.
Wonderful. And Sayugita, any piece of advice for the parents listening to this talk?
Yes, surely. Actually, the parents, when they like put their children into game or something like that, like any sport, so they shouldn't force them. They let them enjoy the game, and they shouldn't be like, "Arey, nahi, ye tournament khelna hai na, ye jeetna hai." So it doesn't work like that. Like everybody is not that talented, or स्टार्टिंग में उतना सक्सेस किसी को नहीं मिलता, लाइक वेरी फ्यू लाखों में एक को मिल जाता है वैसा सक्सेस, बट एवरीबडी एल्स वो सब हार्ड वर्क करके आएंगे. सो योर चाइल्ड नीड्स टू नो दैट ही और शी वोंट गेट एनीथिंग ऐसा रेडीमेड. सो वैसा उनको उनका माइंड सेट बनाओ, एंड डोंट फोर्स देम, कि मतलब गिव देम स्मॉल चैलेंजेस कि हाँ अभी. Like my coach used to do, like I like to share this with you. My coach used to do that. One tournament, like when I was 8-9 year old, one tournament I was supposed to play. He asked me, draws aane ke baad, are tera to first seed ke saath quarter finals hai. And I lost to her in previous tournament. So he just said me, ki tune agar quarter final jeeta, I'll give you one racket. And pink and purple was my favorite color. So they were he got one pink purple color small racket for me, and he kept it in front of me. Aur wo dekh ke mere ko aisa lag raha tha na, nahi yaar ye racket ke liye to khelna hai. So bachpan mein kaisa hota hai ki chote chote agar tum log unko challenges doge, they are like when they grow old, they'll be ready for the bigger challenges with the maturity they'll grow with. So I went for that tournament. मेरे को वो रैकेट ही मतलब अरे वो रैकेट के लिए खेलना ही है. आई वन दैट टूर्नामेंट, लाइक यू वोंट बिलीव. आई बीट दैट टॉप सीड को, जो कुछ कोई थी, मैंने उसको हारा है, मैंने फाइनल जीता. एंड मैं मतलब तभी मैं कोल्हापुर में खेलती थी, पुणे में स्टेट टूर्नामेंट था. आई वेंट रनिंग, मतलब मैं जिस दिन पहुंची ना पुणे, आई डायरेक्टली कोल्हापुर आई वेंट टू हिज प्लेस डायरेक्टली, रैकेट लेने, मेरा रैकेट दे दो, मेरा रैकेट दे दो. मतलब मुझे कुछ पड़ी नहीं थी. सो इट्स लाइक जो इनोसेंस रहता है बच्चों में, सो वो रख के उनको गेम एंजॉय करना सिखाओ. नॉट दैट कि यू आर पुटिंग सो मच प्रेशर ऑन दैट स्मॉल किड कि मतलब वो एंजॉय करना भूल जाए एंड ही मतलब वो ऐसा डर के खेले. लाइक आई सी सो मेनी किड्स, लाइक दे स्टार्ट क्राइंग एंड पेरेंट्स आर येलिंग फ्रॉम आउटसाइड. माय पेरेंट्स, माय डैड, तो आई टेल यू ही हार्डली सॉ मी प्लेइंग. अभी भी वो कभी कभी आते. एंड वन तो आई रिमेम्बर ही केम फॉर दैट नागपुर नेशनल्स एंड आई फेंटेड इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिम एंड आई गॉट एडमिटेड. उसमें उनको इतना टेंशन आ गया था. बट देन इट्स लाइक your parents play a major role, like your coach, your parents, like the people you surround with yourself. So it's like very important ki matlab tum kin ke sath reh rahe ho, kaisa mindset hai. To keep your mindset positive, you have to surround yourself with positivity.
True. And you know, if there is a pressure from parents and coach, even the kid is not able to express himself or herself on the coach, which
so
is
aadha game dar mein hi nikal
jata. Exactly. The so fear the coach as well as from the parent.
See, failures aayenge, but then they need to even celebrate their failures. Ki theek hai, chal abhi hua hai na, baad mein nahi hoga. You have to work more harder for it.
Exactly. So, very true. Yeah.
सो बचपन से अगर वैसा उनको ट्रीट किया जाए, वो सिखाया जाए, देन इट विल बी इजीयर फॉर देम.
एंड सयोगिता, एनी पीस ऑफ एडवाइस फॉर ऑल द प्लेयर्स लिसनिंग टू दिस?
यस,
don't give up, stay at it, and injuries, mainly injuries honge, but then don't give up. You have to come out of every time you fall. So yeah, that's all. And good luck.
Before we sign off, Sayogita, a big congratulations to you for your award, the Shiv Chhatrapati Award, which is the highest sporting honor. So nothing goes above it. So how was the feeling when the name was declared?
I got all goosebumps, and I like, I don't have words to explain that. And I remember Vignesh was there with me, and we were like standing in the line. कि मतलब आगे के स्पोर्ट्स के होने के बाद लाइक बैडमिंटन वाज थर्ड और फोर्थ एंड आई वाज स्टैंडिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ विग्नेश आई वाज लाइक यार मेरे पैर ही नहीं चल रहे मैं कैसे जाऊंगी ऊपर बट इट वाज रियली नाइस लाइक रियली प्राउड फीलिंग एंड माय मॉम डैड माय मामा माय काका हिज वाइफ एवरीबॉडी वाज देयर एंड one of my sister who is into boxing even she was there she had won a medal in Khelo India so that function was together so everybody was so proud my parents had tears in their eyes actually when I started crying I am emotional kind of a person so utna chalta hai
no no that's wonderful because you know it's probably the result of all the 18 to 20 years of hard work
yeah,
which you
actually,
have put in
like I was actually like when I was sitting there like we had these chairs of our own name on it in the VIP section and then with that feta and stuff like
true,
it was
true.
Really nice when I sat there and they were tying the feta I was feeling so proud matlab aisa ek talwar walwar de do mujhe such actually wo Chhatrapati wala feeling aa raha tha nice
so Sayogita what are your plans for the next 2 years which tournaments are you targeting
actually because of this pandemic it's really difficult to plan anything as of now but then once everything ends or like once the national training center and everything opens and I go back to Hyderabad I would like to first like check on me my own cells and train for at least 30-40 days or maybe more than that and once I feel confident and then I can start planning my tournaments but till then I'll be just training because it's been a long break and even if I work out like home workout and stuff I'm doing it's okay for the core strength but main jo badminton ke liye jo footwork chahiye and all that I won't get like doing my home workout so sure. For that I really need to get back on court soon and start training
okay and Sayogita there are still many more messages coming for you there's one from Deepak Naidu you remember Vishesh Naidu
yeah
his father he is congratulating you for all your achievements and he's wishing you the best luck
thank you so much
yeah so again Bhakti Avinash Prakash everyone is wishing you all the best
thank you everyone thank you so much
so Sayogita
keep supporting
yeah thank you so much for joining us
thank
it was
you.
Wonderful
thank you for
talking
having me here.
Yeah it was wonderful talking to you yeah. All the best for all the future tournaments and we'll meet soon
yes
yeah. bye Sayogita
bye.
Thank you so much bye everyone bye. Thank you for joining
bye. Bye everyone thank you so much
bye Sayogita bye, bye.